Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we are starting our meal prep series. I am so excited about this because meal prep is one of the best things that I started integrating into my routine. It's so simple, there's not much to it, and it makes your week so much easier because you don't have to think about what you're gonna eat every single day. It's already prepared, and if you're short of time, this is a lifesaver. Finding things that you like it doesn't have to be broccoli, chicken breast, and rice every single day. It could be something fun. It could be recipes that you enjoy. It doesn't have to be something that you are gonna dread every single week or get gross out by every single day. So this is why I'm excited to show you this specific meal prep, because this has to be one of my favorite meal preps ever. It is the chicken thigh stir fry. Over here, I have my chicken thighs. I have 10 chicken thighs. Each of them are about 100 grams each. I do 10 because then that means I'll have 2 chicken thighs per day since I'm only doing a 5-day meal prep. I have all my seasonings here plus salt, and this is the oil that I'll be using today. It is extra virgin olive oil. There's no other oil that I'm going to be using, so this will be used for my chicken thighs and on the pan. Then I have an assortment of veggies that have already been peeled, cut, and cleaned. I'm going to be using a bunch of asparagus, a bunch of broccolini, I would say they're called. I've been trying to find broccolini in the store, but for some reason it's impossible. This is called mini broccoli. It looked like broccolini. I'm in love with broccolini, so this is why I got it. I definitely like broccolini way better than regular broccoli. Don't know what it is. It's literally the exact same family, but they're different. Anyways, we also have a red pepper, which we're gonna chop, and then we have 3 garlic cloves and about 1/4 of a medium white onion. And then to top it all off, we have our rice. Now for rice, I already cooked this. I put 2 cups of uncooked rice into a pot, and I did a 2-to-1 ratio. So I put 2 cups of uncooked rice and then 4 cups of water. I put it on high heat. I stirred it occasionally. And then once it reached a boil, I brought it down to a simmer. I let it simmer, stirring it occasionally for about 10 minutes or until it was fully cooked. Now, because I kind of like my rice to be crisp in my stir fry. I don't want it to become too much of a mush. So I'm gonna pop it into the fridge while I cut up these veggies and start on the stir fry. And I'll only take it out until I'm ready to add it into the pan. So once your rice is fully cooked, let it cool down a little bit, pop it into the fridge, continue your other stuff, and then add it to the pan later. Okay, so I'm gonna pop this in the fridge. All right, let's get started. Okay, this is going to be the most tedious part of this meal prep, but I promise it is worth it in the end. What I do is with every single vegetable, I cut them into very tiny pieces. With the pepper and the carrot, I'm gonna dice them into small cubes. With the broccolini, the asparagus, I'm going to cut them into small, small pieces. And then with my garlic, I'm gonna mince them. And my onion, I'm going to also cut it into very small pieces. I find that the smaller they are, the faster they cook, the faster I'm done. You know what I mean? Since it's no secret that I'm not a professional chef, I'm gonna fast forward this slow cutting to when we're ready to put it into the pan. Okay, I kid you not, that was the fastest I've ever cut veggies in my life. It's my least favorite time, onion and garlic time. I actually hate cutting onion and garlic. This makes me cry all the time. This makes my fingers smell like garbage. I don't really know how to mince garlic. I think I took only 1 cooking class in high school and still don't know. I feel like that should have been lesson 1. Also a goal of mine not to cut myself. Why will I cut this garlic? Because it has the least amount of surface area ever. Now I forgot about the chicken, but it's super quick, okay? Quick drizzle of extra virgin olive oil. This is about 1 to 2 tablespoons. Some paprika, oregano. So I would say that's about 1 teaspoon of paprika, 1 teaspoon of oregano, 1 teaspoon of Italian seasoning, 1 teaspoon garlic powder, 1/2 teaspoon of chili flakes, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Okay, now that we have all of that in the bowl, we're just gonna move it around, massage it with our hands, really make sure that all the seasoning is evenly incorporated into the chicken thighs. Everything is evenly incorporated, and now we're going to add it into the air fryer. Okay, so we got our air fryer plugged in and ready to go. We're just gonna pop in the chicken thighs. Now, my air fryer is small, but it is my mission to make sure that I fit in all 10 chicken thighs because I do not wanna do 2 rounds of cooking. Yuck. It's just the sliminess, like, oh, Gross. Okay, we fit all our chicken thighs in. Now I'm gonna cook it at 390 Fahrenheit. And we're also going to cook it for about 20 minutes. I like my chicken to be kind of on the crispier side, so I make it run almost 20 minutes. I check around the 15 minute mark, shake it around, flip if I need to, and then put it in for an extra 5 minutes. But if you don't want yours to be super crispy, you can just check on it every so often until it's fully cooked. Here we go. Now that our chicken thighs are in the air fryer and cooking, we're gonna start with the pan portion. And we are going to start by turning on to, I would say, low medium heat for this portion. We're gonna add about a tablespoon of extra virgin olive oil. Once that has heated up for about 15 seconds, we're gonna add our onion. But just because the onion takes a little longer to become translucent, we're gonna add the garlic a bit later. Now, depending on how much onion you did cut, you might need to add a bit more olive oil. And I'm going to do that because there's gonna be a lot of veg that I'm gonna add as well. So just the tiniest bit. Okay, so our onion has gotten a bit more translucent. So now we're gonna add our garlic in, mix it in. Next up, I'm gonna add my carrots. Mix them around a little bit. Now at this point, you might have to add some more olive oil. It's really just depending on how your veggies are eating it up. Now at this point, I'm also going to add in my broccoli, my mini broccoli, because I find that the carrots and the broccoli are gonna be the longest to cook. I'm gonna add a little bit more olive oil. Stir that around. And we're really just gonna wait until the broccoli and the carrots begin to soften. In a couple minutes, I'm gonna add in my asparagus because I find that that is the next veggie that takes the longest to cook. Stir that around. Time to add in the peppers. Now at this point, while they steam up, I'm going to add some salt. And I'm also gonna add some chili flakes. Continue to stir around. You can also add a lid on top to help soften the vegetables more with their steam. But since I don't have a lid that fits this pan, I'm just gonna let it continue to simmer on low medium heat until the veggies soften to my liking. I do like my veggies to be a little bit crisp, so I'll just wait until they get to that texture, and then I can add in my eggs. I've pushed my veggies to one side because now I'm gonna add 2 eggs. And I'm gonna quickly just make sure that they don't cook into a scramble too much. Okay, now I'm gonna mix in my veggies with it. And I'm really just gonna keep stirring until all the egg is cooked completely through. Okay, perfect. I'm gonna bring it down to a simmer. Okay, my veggies have now gotten to a point where they're soft enough to my liking. So now I'm going to add in my rice. Slowly adding in the rice. I don't wanna make a mess. Okay, so I added about half my rice. I'm gonna stir it in so it's not too shocking all at once. Okay, let's add in the rest of our rice. This part just takes a lot of patience and a lot of arm work. But eventually we'll get to a good spot. I'm going to add some soy sauce. Usually I also use some chili lime sauce, but I don't have that, unfortunately. So I'm just gonna add some soy sauce, which will be good on its own. I kind of just drizzle it around. This is all up to preference how much soy sauce you like. But I would say that I put about 1/4 cup soy sauce to 1/2 cup soy sauce. I just wanna make sure that a lot of it is covered. And keep stirring until everything is incorporated. Now at this point, I would give it a little bit of a taste test and see if you wanna add a bit more salt, a bit more pepper, or some soy sauce, or any other seasoning that you would like. Now that we have taste tested it, it's good to go. It is time to add it to our containers. Okay, we had to add a little bit more light. It is so rainy outside. So the chicken is all done, and now we're gonna cut it up into small pieces because it's just easier to eat. You don't have to have a knife and fork with you. So I'm gonna chop them up and then place two chicken thighs into every dish. This chicken is so juicy. Like, once I've started using the air fryer, there's really no going back. This air fryer is just so easy. All right. Okay, there we go. So I just made three dishes. I have about two more dishes worth in this pan. What I'm gonna do is, once these have cooled down, everything has cooled down, I'm gonna pop it into the fridge, but I'm just gonna pop these three containers into the fridge. The remaining two I'm gonna separate into two portions. So I'll separate the rice portion into two and then put two chicken thighs in each dish. And I'm gonna pop that into the freezer because chicken goes bad after 3 days. So that's the best way that I found to preserve chicken when I'm making it for the full 5 days. When you wanna defrost it, just the night before, pop it into the fridge, let it defrost overnight, and then by the next day, it should be good to go. You can microwave it, put it into a pan, whatever you'd like to reheat it. And then for my everyday salad, I've been making this nonstop. It's just one cucumber chopped up with a red pepper and a yellow pepper, and then some feta and red onion. And I don't season it. I only season it the day that I'm going to eat it because I find that putting olive oil and salt and pepper will kind of make the veggies soften over the week. So I just season the day of with a little bit of olive oil, salt and pepper, and then good to go. So I'm gonna pop all these into the fridge and we are good. Thank you so much for following along with me with my first ever meal prep on YouTube. Let me know if you guys want to continue seeing more of my meal preps, what I do every single week. But yeah, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and let me know what you want to see next. But until then, I will see you in the next video. I love you so much. Bye.